I haven't done a video update on building work for quite a while, simply because there hasn't been any building work done. But after a bit of a hiatus over the past few months or half year, it's time to return up to the attic and try and get this back on the road a bit. Towards the end of last year, we got underflooring done, so I finished the underconstruction on the floor up here. Which was a really great thing to do. It made a huge difference to be able to walk around. But now I need to start basically doing the cladding on the inside of the roof surface there. I'm going to do this with OSB sheets, very thin ones, to basically balance out because it's not very even. So this will give some sort of, an easier underground to work with. And then we'll basically screw plasterboards onto those. It's going to be a little bit tricky because of the beams and the posts around the place. And then this dividing wall, we need to do something here to make an actual door. So anyway, this is one half here, and if you look down, that is into where the future second bathroom is going to be. So basically where this line is here, there's going to be a wall here, so this will all be closed off, so we won't be able to look down on top of people showering or something. But the bathroom will be as high as the ridge there, so the highest room in the house, I guess. We'll be able to raise our hands and jump up and down around the place, it'd be great. So that'll be closed off, which will mean this is one room here, which is a little bit dark. We couldn't put extensive amounts of roof windows in because it's a protected structure. So we were allowed to put quite narrow ones in between the existing beams, so the structure itself was not affected in any way. But that does mean this particular side is a bit dark. The dormers are below this level slightly, so they're lighting the bedrooms just below, also in the roof space. And if you go over to this side, so this will be the other half, and this is where we have the stairway coming up. So we've actually taken it apart for now. Be careful not to fall down there by mistake. And so we'll reinstate the original stairway there. And on this side, and so this is a hallway. I've already started building the stud partition wall here. And there's a little bit of a step down here to try and conserve as much height as possible. And over here it's much brighter because we were able to put a bigger window here for emergency exit purposes. So the fire department were here, and the fire chief at the time said yes, this would be necessary. And of course that overrides any of the protection. So one of the beams was cut out a bit to make for a large window that opens fully in case of fire, because otherwise it's quite hard to get down. So I'm going to start, I've already started doing the sides here. I'm going to put a slight vertical part here, and then the rest will be all sloped. That gable wall is pretty much done. The heating is done in the wall. Plastering is done, just needs to be skimmed, and then we're going to leave this open up to the apex, perhaps floor part of it just for a little bit of storage, but definitely on the other side of the partition that will be partially floored, so we can like put boxes or suitcases up there. But it's such a nice space, it'd be really great to leave that open and have lighting up above all those beams. And have a really nice bright room in here, either for visitors or kind of an office hobby space. We definitely need a spare room for visitors, but we also need that kind of storagey space. So let's see how far I get. It's hot, it's 30 degrees outside. All the heat in the house, that's fairly cool compared to outside, but any heat that is in the house is right raising up to here. And if I open the windows, it'll probably get even hotter. So it's going to be quite sauna-like for the next while. Let's see how far I get, if I get sick of it.